A lot of people were surprised that the new homes sales numbers actually dropped last month. And I'm going to talk about the real story behind the stimulus package, as well as the joblessness in September and the real reason why the numbers dropped. Hello, it's August 29th, 2009. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as DemCad. First, I want to talk about new home sales. Basically, they fell for the first time since March, and a lot of people were taken by surprise. The Commerce Department reported that the sales dropped 3.6% in September. It fell to a seasonally adjusted annual rate of 402,000. So we're seeing a drop-off. They actually expected the sales to continue to go up because there's a tax credit for anyone who's buying a new house or a first-time homeowner going out and actually buying a house. I believe it's like $7,000 or is it $8,000? I think it's somewhere around $8,000 if you never own a home, you go out and you actually buy a house. So there are some incentives, and that sort of surprised people. People were surprised that the numbers were actually down. I guess the tax credit can only do so much. Joe Lieberman apparently is going to block Harry Reid's plan. This is the health care bill. And basically he's saying that he's not going to support a government-run insurance program. So basically Joe Lieberman is going to join the Republicans in creating a filibuster to block this health care bill. And at this point, I want to know, are you guys even interested in the healthcare bill? Do you think it's really going to be relevant? Do you think the government's really going to be able to do all the things that they're trying to do at this point? Because at this point, it looks like this country is actually headed towards possibly a revolution, if not a massive reform revolution. Things are changing dramatically in this country. The economy is getting much, much worse. So do you think the government's going to be even able to implement the type of changes that they want at this point? 30,000 stimulus jobs. This is a figure that's been thrown around by the White House, and it turns out that this number is slightly inaccurate. Actually, it's very inaccurate. A Colorado company said that they created 4,231 jobs with the help of President Obama's economic recovery plan. Well, the real number is actually fewer than 1,000. And that's not just an anomaly. And a healthcare center in Florida said that they were able to save 229 jobs with the help of the stimulus package. But what they really did was give the current employees raises. So it obviously wasn't used to really save the jobs. And what the government did is they used a oversight board weeks ago to make a claim that contracts that are being awarded to businesses have basically helped pay for 30,000 jobs. That was a claim that the White House was making. But in reality, it looks like at the very least, nearly 5,000 of those jobs didn't really happen. Basically, people were making false reports. And in some instances, some companies were saying that they created 10 times the amount of jobs than they actually did. They'd say, well, for example, we created 100 jobs when they only created 10 jobs. And some companies apparently just made it all up to begin with. There were some instances where no jobs were produced at all. So this is kind of strange, and it's not very surprising. So it gives you an idea of what's really going on with this stimulus package. Metro jobless rates fall in September. This sounds like good news. In September, the unemployment rate fell in 223 out of 380 metro areas. This is about 59%. It sounds really good. The jobless rate actually rose in 123 metro areas, and it stayed the same in 34 areas. Well, what's happening is people are falling off the unemployment rolls, and they're simply stopping their search for a new job. They get to a point where they stop looking for a new job, they're not collecting unemployment anymore, and so they're counted as not being a part of the labor force. And that's how the government gets these numbers down, when they say, oh, well, if you've been unemployed for a certain amount of time, you're not collecting unemployment, you're not actively looking for a job, then all of a sudden you just disappear from the universe and you don't really count as being a part of the workforce. So that's how they're able to bury that. That's how they're able to say, oh, well, the unemployment rate is only 9.8% or whatever. So, I mean, you get to a point where people are going to have to face reality. And I hope people are looking beyond the smoke and mirrors. The stock market is not going to impact your life, okay? If it hits 15,000, it's not going to change anything in your life if unemployment continues to go up. So it's just something that you guys got to think about. I hope you guys are thinking about it. I know a lot of you are thinking about it. So tell me, how long do you think it's going to take for people to realize what's really going on in the economy? At what point do you think people are going to start to wake up to what the government's been doing and wake up to the fact that this is not just a recession and we're not going through a recovery? Will it take 6 months from now, a year? I don't know. You guys tell me. So please rate my video, comment if you have something to say, and I look forward to reading them, and have a good day. Bye.